So a councilman for the city of New Milford in Connecticut, Democrat Scott Chamberlain, recently resigned for being a secret furry after his profile on the furry site SoFurry.com was revealed. My God, this guy, he's just... I'm a talking cartoon lizard. I am not allowed to criticize. So there's this website called Verrit.com. It presents itself as being the liberal, socialistic alternative to Twitter and Facebook and general social media, as if they weren't liberal or socialistic enough. It's been endorsed by Hillary Rodham Clinton, so you know it must be good. Let's check it out and see if it lives up to the hype. Oh. Oh no. Oh no 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 no. Look at it! Forget about the text on the screen, I mean just look at it. The text is so prominent that your eyes go right for it, but just focus on the design of this website for a second. Gray. Gray on gray on gray on gray on gray. Yeah, that's eye-catching. Doesn't make your site look as bland, humorless, and sterile as your ideology. Not at all. But wait, there's a little splash of UN blue right there. Yeah, that helps makes it all better. Now... what about these buttons at the top here? Information, hashtag, search, email, no login screen? God, what kind of social media site does this? Well, let's just click on info. Verrit collects and contextualizes noteworthy facts, stats, and quotes for politically engaged citizens. Each Verrit is a verified item of information marked with a 7-digit identification code. To authenticate a Verrit, enter the code in the search bar and match it to our database. So basically, Verrit's a safe space for fake news journalists to have their lies made into sterile gray memes. I wonder what happens when you try to authenticate a Verrit. Oh, you have got to be kidding me! I can't copy-paste that code? Fine, I'll just memorize it. Don't you just love it when you click on something and it appears all the way on the other side of the screen? It doesn't work. You had one job, Verrit code. One job! Now let's see what these hashtags do. So we have categories. Only 8 though, but why? Can't users make their own hashtags? Anyways, let's just go into politics. So it seems that all it does is sort Verrits by categories that happen to take the form of hashtags, rather than let users make their own hashtags like, you know, Twitter, or Gab, or pretty much any social media site. I guess hashtags are just the hip and cool thing, so Verrit has to have it, even if they don't know what the point of hashtags even is. So we've seen most of what this site has to offer, and I don't care what the email button does. Let's just go ahead and actually click on a Verrit and see what happens. So it looks to be some kind of article with a full text published. I mean, okay. But look, there's a comment section. Therefore, signing up is totally worth it, you guys. And it's definitely not going to be like any other news site ever. I mean, really, just through my search of this site, it looks like a news aggregator site collecting socialist articles, quotes, and what have you. I wouldn't really call this a social media site, like, by any standard definition. It's great if you're a hysterical progressive, but for us sane, rational people, its only value isn't being a source of endless, stupid articles for me to debunk in the future. Or it would be if the site's design wasn't so awful. Yeah, stick to George Report, or 4chan.